Well,
to the sporting world, by the way.
Let's just say that that would have been a very interesting couple of phone calls to be on. Number one, Brady and Gronkowski discussing him coming out of retirement. I mean, let us not forget, the man just won the 24/7 WWE wrestling title at WrestleMania like 2 weeks ago, and now suddenly is Bammo back in the NFL. So that would have been a very interesting conversation. And then, oh, to have been a listening party when Brady hangs up the phone and calls Buccaneer general manager Jason Light. Hey, Jason, I just talked to Gronk, and you might want to call the New England Patriots and make a trade. I love it.
Unbelievable.
That would be wild to have been on one or both of those phone calls on how this came about. So it's crazy, and here we go. Yes.
Before we get into that, I got a little bone to pick with the Parks Department in Tampa. Listen, there's a phone call from the University of Tennessee police officers, Knoxville police officers, and our recording of Jeremy Pruitt talking to an officer while arresting a Tennessee player, giving him a little bit of advice. Hey, man, do your civic duty, okay? Do your civic duty and let my kid off the hook for this. Now, I'm not going to get into what that kid was dealing with, but somebody in Tampa needs to do their civic duty and leave my guy Tom alone.
Okay, so let's get into the full breakdown of this. So where Brady is staying is in Derek Jeter's home. He is renting, and home doesn't do it justice, guys. You probably have talked about it. The fans on Winning Cures have probably seen something about it. This thing is a mini hotel. Yes. It is bigger than even a compound. I mean, it is huge. And so that is on an island called Davis Island that is right off of downtown Tampa, right behind the hockey arena where the Tampa Bay Lightning play, among other things. And so I used to live on Davis Island when young TJ was a middle schooler and the family moved from Tennessee to Florida. We lived on Davis Island, and I lived about a half mile from where that compound is down on East Davis Boulevard. Now, I'm not gonna make it seem like we lived in a ritzy house. We lived in a lower middle class, one story, probably about 1,800 to 2,000 square foot house, about a half mile down the street. Talk about how the lower half lives or how the other end lives. That's how we were living. But anyway, I am familiar with the park that they are talking about on Davis Island. Now let's be serious for half a second. All right, so you're Tom Brady. And you do have this compound. I guess you could run laps around the compound, but with everybody floating up on boats on the backside of that residence trying to take pictures and video of him, you knew that would have been on TMZ or on the internet in a hurry if he's out there in a jogging suit or something trying to get a workout in or do something on the property. So he can't go work out at the Buccaneers facility. Everything is in lockdown mode, so he goes to this park. Now, here's the interesting part of the story. It was not the Tampa police that came and did this. It was actually an employee of the Tampa Parks and Recreation, a female, and there were numerous people in the park that either jumped over the locked gate or the areas of that park to get into the park and run around and do it. And she went in and she was citing, C-I-T-I-N-G, citing everybody that was in there and apparently didn't know who he was until she walked up to him and said, I need your name because I am citing you for trespassing here in the park. And how crazy is that part of the story?
Oh, just unbelievable. Unbelievable. It makes you wonder, you know, we're so focused on sports that we have no idea how anybody could not know who Tom Brady is.
Right.
There are still a large number of people in this country that would have no idea. Like, he can be in the same city. He could have won all those championships for Tampa. And there are people in Tampa that would not have a clue what he looks
like. That's true.
So it kind of brings it back to reality.
Yeah, well, you got to think, too, though, Davis Island is not that big. Davis Island's got a few, you know, maybe 1,000 homes that are on it. It's got some small businesses and restaurants. Tampa General Hospital, which is the largest hospital in the area, is right across the street from that Brady Jeter compound. And that's it on Davis Island. It's not very big. So it's just interesting that she would be a Parks and Rec employee working at that park and would not know, apparently, that that's him, even though he lives on Davis Island. But that is apparently how the story went down. Somehow, I don't think there will be any prosecution on this one. It was just more or less a warning, but he's trying to get a workout in. I guess they got to be a little more discreet about where they're going and what they're doing.
Now, you got that right. Let's go ahead and talk about Gronk. You said he.